Hi lovelies, I'm Christina, and today I'm here with my good friend Alex.
Hi.
And for this Vlogmas video, we're just gonna talk quickly about a book that we buddy read, which is Mr. Fox by Helen Oyeyemi. Is that how you say it?
Yeah, I think so. That's how I heard other people
okay.
say it.
Okay, well then we're gonna say that's how you say it.
Yeah, so it's not our fault if it's
no,
wrong.
Don't blame us. So I'm horrible with trying to explain this book. Do you want to give it a try?
Sure. So it kind of follows this writer named Mr. Fox, and his marriage is a little bit on the rocks, but he's very into his books, and he creates this character named, it's Mary, right?
Mary, yeah.
Named Mary, and she kind of sort of comes to life. Like, he gets really so into the story that she's able to interact with his everyday life and becomes sort of intrusive, and that's sort of what the story is about.
Yeah, she takes over a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And there's also the wife of Mr. Fox, Daphne, who also gets involved in this kind of drama between the two.
Yeah.
And, well, for me, I don't know for you, but for me, the most confusing thing about this book was that I was never really sure if Mary was a real character or not.
Right.
Or if she was just something he imagined being there. Then again, I think I was overthinking it.
Yeah. No, I had the same experience where I was just like, because initially he is the only one that interacts with Mary. So I was like, okay, so it's like an imaginary friend type
yeah.
thing. And then she starts interacting with people outside of his home.
Yeah. And then you have certain chapters where you see things from Mary's point of view. And that's where I got really confused, because I'm like, if she's an imaginary character, you can't see things from her perspective unless that's something he's writing.
Yeah.
Which was my thought when we first got those kind of chapters.
And I'm curious if you would think about it this way too. It's like, us as writers, when we release characters out into the world, it doesn't necessarily become ours anymore. It's like we see, like, I mean, Star Wars, for instance, it's not George Lucas's anymore. There's so many people that have
yeah.
made it their own too. And I think that that's part of it, but it's also, I think for me, the most fascinating part of it was how a writer can get so far into his story
yeah.
that he loses contact with people
that
he cares about.
Caught up.
Yeah.
And I see that with writing too. When I write, my characters do kind of live a life of their own at some point, and they do take over, and you dream about them, and you go around and you think about them, and maybe this is kind of just the extreme version of that.
Yeah.
That's kind of maybe a thing they're trying to portray. There was also an underlying, like, fairy tale thing going on here, which I realized afterwards that I didn't know about this fairy. Now I don't remember the name of it either. But parts of it was very much focused on that old fairy tale that I didn't know of. So I think that would have made more sense for me.
Yeah.
If I would have had that background for it and known the story,
because there are parts of the book where I was debating whether or not it was real, because Mr. Fox and Mary would go to places and it would just feel kind of out of context, but I was like, is this them living out their own story, or is this a place that actually exists?
Yeah, but I think we agreed on the thing that made this book confusing for sure is that we both tried to overanalyze it.
Yes.
For a long time.
Yeah.
It's a very meta kind of book. You can't go into it trying to overanalyze it, because it won't work.
Yeah, because that's not the point.
And no.
It's beautifully written.
A very
beautifully
written.
I was never bored.
No, me neither. I was just very confused.
Yeah, but it's like there's a point where you have to kind of shut your brain off and just kind of
read for the pleasure of the story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's really good. I mean, I would recommend it.
Yeah.
If
you like a sort of peculiar, different kind of story, and where you don't have a certain start and a certain finish, because I don't feel like there were, then I would highly recommend it, for sure.
Yeah, like if you're really into books or movies that have like analogies for things, like if they're characters that are not characters, they're analogies for stuff.
Yeah.
Like I think if you're into that sort of thing, you'll love it. But if not, then you're going to not.
If you don't like being slightly confused for longer periods of time, this might not be for you. But it was a fun read. It was different.
Yeah, good pick, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm excited for the next book we're going to read together that you picked.
Yeah. Do you want to tell them what
we can do that?
Yeah.
You want to talk about it? You want to show it? It's right there.
Oh, yeah. That's good.
Conveniently placed. Let's pretend that it was supposed to be like that.
Yeah, because that was planned.
Yeah.
So we're reading Hungry Moon, which is what I picked out. It's by Ramsey Campbell. He's a horror author that I've admired, but somehow I've never read.
No, me neither.
But a lot of people have recommended this book to me because it has a creature in it that it kind of comes from underground, but it doesn't. It's kind of like mysterious. But I thought this would be an interesting one for us to do.
Yeah. So I'm excited.
Yeah.
Like, weird horror. I like it.
Me too.
Dark and twisted.
Yeah.
Just the way we like it.
All the way.
Well, yeah. So that's our short and sweet. Short and sweet review.
We can't give away too much.
No.
It ruins it. Would you read anything else by this author?
Yeah. I would love to read other stuff by...
Me too.
I have actually been looking at some of her other books, but, you know, the TBR pile is... piling up for sure.
Oh yeah, mine's the same way. Or if it would topple over, it would probably squish me.
Yeah, like every book lover's problem right there. But yeah, I would definitely try to read something else by her at some point. So yeah, short and sweet review. That's gonna be the Vlogmas video of the day. And now we're gonna go out and find some Norwegian bookstores.
Yeah, I'm so glad that I got to be here and physically do this with
you.
Yeah, it makes it a lot easier.
It's going to be so much easier to edit.
No kidding.
So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. And subscribe to both of our channels. I will link both of them at the end of the video. And I will see you guys tomorrow.
Toodles.
Bye.